Hi YouTube, it is November 3rd, 2012. We're back here to harvest some potatoes for the year, and I haven't pulled all these brassicas out that didn't produce, but look it! I've got broccoli! I was gonna pull these all out, and I've got broccoli! At least a few here and there! Isn't that wild? I mean, they're small, they've been through a couple frosts, but there they are! And I didn't think I was going to have any, but I do have some, oh, I know, we'll get to those. I do have some Brussels sprouts. My kids are not thrilled, but I am. They're my favorite.
I'm okay with them.
Yeah, you're okay with them.
I'll eat them in butter.
So, I'm going to be harvesting those today and having Brussels sprouts. No, not all of them produce like this one. It's pretty sad, isn't it? But, and that one... Nah, that one's got some aphid problem going on. But we'll see what we can find. You know, beggars can't be choosers this time of the year. But I'm just so shocked at this broccoli. I mean, it didn't have a chance this fall or this summer. So it's...
Cauliflower, Mama!
It's going right now. I know, and the cauliflower heads have done something really interesting. They've made these funky kind of looking heads. But...
Maybe they'll
be edible. I don't know.
I don't want to get paper.
I'm kind of glad I didn't get around to pulling this all out because it's been rather interesting. Yeah. Yeah, it's just been interesting to see what these plants will do. I mean, they want to make flowers for the year, so they're trying to play catch up.
And look at all these, Mommy. Look how big they are.
Oh, my goodness sakes. Yeah, we're going to have to harvest.
They're all the size of my palm.
We're going to have to harvest.
Broccoli.
Some broccoli.
Cool.
You know, I've always thought I should raise broccoli in the fall. Try to start seeds in the summer for a fall plant or a fall harvest. And now I'm pretty convinced of it.
Look at Mommy.
I think that's going to be next year's plan.
They're making seeds.
I know, babe. Isn't that something? There's more. Well, anyway, we better get to the potatoes. I'm going to throw Mr. Stinky over there. One of these, he won't eat it, honey. One of these old cabbages, or maybe they're cauliflower. I think they're cauliflower. Just to keep him happy so he doesn't bug us. The other thing we're going to be harvesting besides the potatoes are these turnips. Nobody liked them, so I'm going to harvest them and cook them up over the winter here and there for the chickens. One of them went rotten. I heard they got sweeter after frost, so I might try them again with the family, but I'm not hopeful. But we'll be pulling them, you know, years ago, hundreds of years ago. Root crops were what farmers fed their animals over the winter. Not so much grains and hay, but things just like this. Mango beets, turnips, rutabagas, you know. And so I thought, well, if I cook them, maybe the animals will eat them. I tried giving them to the pigs raw. They didn't do anything with them except ignore them. So I'm thinking if I cook them, they might go over better with everybody. We'll see. Okay, we got all our potatoes in, or probably most of them. We'll find out next spring when they start sprouting out there. These are the Pontiac Reds, and we had I'm going to say 15 to 18 foot rows. Did not get a huge amount of them. I'm going to guesstimate about 60 pounds just from the weight of the bag. Some of them were very large, however, like this little behemoth here. That is a weird, lumpy, bumpy potato. This one's good size too. But most of them are on the small side or regular side. I really was hoping to get more, but I think the drought definitely contributed because the biggest potatoes and the most potatoes were found towards the end of the garden by the corn, which got watered quite heavily. So the potatoes down there definitely benefited from the yield anyway. The Yukon Golds, which are down here, didn't do as well. There was probably only about 40 pounds of them, maybe 50. And a lot of them are small. I'm going to put my hand in here so you can see. I mean, this is not a bad size, but a lot of them are this size. And Yeah, again, I think it was the drought. Although your Yukon Golds are a determinate potato rather than an indeterminate potato, just like with tomatoes. So they're only going to produce so much and then they're going to stop. But usually I get a little better yield. But it was a drought year, so I guess we can't be too choosy. This bag contains what we call our wounded soldiers. And they're the potatoes that I accidentally spear and spike when I'm digging. And I'll clean those up and can those up so that they don't go to waste, because they don't do well in storage. If you accidentally spear one with your turning fork, or if you use a shovel or whatever you use to dig your potatoes, if you damage them, you have to eat them right away. Don't try to store them, because they will get icky and then infect the rest of them. So that was our potato crop this year. I'm going to guess about 120 pounds, maybe 130, but no more than that. And I planted probably, 30, 40 pounds of potatoes. So not a huge yield, not terrible, but hopefully next year better. I'm probably not going to be planting Yukon Gold, much as we love them. They are our favorite potato. But I want something that's going to produce better for me. So I'm going to be looking for something else. Love the Yukon Golds, but just need something that's a little bit better. And I see one I speared. See, something like that. You can still salvage that potato, but just use it up really fast. Or right away, or can it, or whatever. Dehydrate it. So there you go. I cooked up those strange heads of cauliflower that came on late this season, and the Brussels sprouts, and I cooked them up for the chickens. The reason we're not going to eat them is because they were very heavily infested with aphids. The broccoli not so much, and I put that in the freezer. Got a big package of that. But for some reason, the Brussels sprouts and the cauliflower were just covered with them. So I didn't get them clean enough to where I felt comfortable cooking them for us, but I'm sure the chickens won't mind if there's the occasional aphid here and there. And I cooked them just to make them more appealing to the chickens. I'm going to let them cool off out here in the garage and then give those to the chickens later. They'll enjoy that, leaves and all. So, you know, nothing goes to waste around here. Usually, no matter what it is, something around here will eat it. That's all, YouTube.